standing ovation.
Thank you. I am not the one that deserves this applause. It's the people that surround me. It's folks like you that deserve the applause. The senator was talking about how we have prepared for this fire after the Cerro Grande fire, the mitigation. This is a firewise community. We are still on fire. We have not lost any structures at the laboratory or in the town site, and we don't plan on losing any structures. Right now, we're prepping two canyons, Pajarito Canyon and Los Alamos Canyon. We have some of our public works folks, in fact, about 45 people near the ice rink, preparing the ice rink and taking away some of the trees that were there, the smaller trees, and removing it. In fact, we're going to recycle, so we're going green during this fire. And this is our opportunity to take care of that. On the Llano side, we have some buildings that we're adding extra prep to, buildings that we're just taking another layer. We have the time. This fire has laid down on top for today. Right now, I say that, I notice the winds are starting to pick up again. They're coming out of the south, southwest. For us right now, that's good. It made a run for the ski hill last night, and we fought fire last night on the ski hill from about 10 o'clock, and we're continuing to put out spot fires now. It ran to the ridge, and it ran over and spotted into the ski hill. The lodge is safe. We were able to put the spot fires out around the lodge. We had some spot fires in the trees, but most of this fire has hooked around and gone on top of Camp May, headed towards Santa Clara Canyon. It has to go through a burn scar to get there. So right now, the fire, as long as it stays on that side and up, we're in good shape. If we get the winds to change and the winds push it down, we will be fighting fire in Los Alamos Canyon and in Pajarito Canyon. In addition, on the south side of the lab, State Route 4, next to Frijoles Canyon, Bandelier, they continue to fight fire in Frijoles Canyon, and we still have a strong anchor on State Route 4. So right now, things are looking good. This is a make or break it day for Los Alamos County, not for the rest of the fire. They have had, they called in two Type 1 teams. They have an area command because they're dividing this fire. It is so big, and the potential exists to go toward Jemez that they are trying to protect the south borders. This is the north side of the fire, and we have our own battle here. But right now, we're feeling pretty good. We have a good anchor. That said, we're not into the heat of the day. We're not into the final burn period. About 6 o'clock tonight, I'll be able to tell you how much better we're doing and whether or not it's going to stay out of Los Alamos Canyon and Pajarito Canyon.
What's the threat in those two canyons?
The threat in those two canyons is during the fire burned over them. So there's unburnt fuels, and we have structures right on the edge of both of those canyons, in Pajarito Canyon and Los Alamos. Los Alamos Canyon is the very next canyon over. The next canyon south of that is Pajarito. So it's some of our main populace hangs over Los Alamos Canyon.
Any containment?
Excuse me, we'll have questions and answers at the end of the.